Right, so you are wondering why do you see the Lightspeed instead of Shopify? It's because I'm going to show you the way how to migrate from Lightspeed to Shopify. And in this tutorial, we'll start by products. So in Lightspeed, I'm going to the product section. And I have here some couple of sample products. I just hit export products. And then I go here to view my exported products. Then I click download. And I have the file here downloaded, which says products export. Now I need to rename it. I need to add it to the name Lightspeed, like this. So that it becomes Lightspeed and products. So like those two words need to be in the file name, Lightspeed and products. Then I'm going to the Shopify admin, the Excelify app. And here in the import section, I just drag and drop this file in the app. And then I see that the app has recognized this as a Lightspeed format. And it found two products here. And just to make sure that my Shopify admin, oops, it has some products. Let's just delete them so that it's empty and we see the clean results of the migration. Yeah, so it's empty now. And actually, for a normal migration, you would want to check your converted file instead of just like importing it directly. So the Excelify offers this capability that you can do the dry run here in the options. You can select this checkbox and press the import. And what it will do, it will just convert this file to the Excelify template file, which you can then review and edit, clean the data and so on. So we download this import results file here. And when we open it, we'll see the usual Excelify template with all the columns. But those come now from the Lightspeed. Yeah, there are all the base columns, the images, the collections. This one indicates whether this is a top row or this is a duplicated row, like for the variants. There are variants. Yeah, sadly, Lightspeed doesn't distinguish the options in their export file, so we just have the option one name, and they give the option title. So you'll have to work with that. You can of course update here in the file all the data so that they become relevant for your Shopify store, but basically they will work anyway without any changes. So you can verify that there are right SKUs, the barcodes, the weight, and so on. The price is very important to check that it's what you need, and the quantity as well. And so, and here with those blue columns, you see there comes the variant meta fields. So we are putting into the variant meta fields and into the product meta fields, whatever fields that come from Lightspeed that we don't have a specific field in Shopify, so that you can anyway use them in your Shopify store afterwards. So it's like this internal variant ID, the price unit, like the units, whatever, the taxes, and all the nitty-bitty tiny things that might be important. Because no matter how tiny the thing is, its details might be important for you. Also, here comes, after the variant meta fields, there comes just the meta field. Those are the product level meta fields. These are the SEO, the SEO title and description, and the meta keywords. But like those are fields that will be recognized by Shopify for the SEO data. This one is meta keywords. It's just in the Lightspeed namespace here, and you can work with it afterwards. But of course, it will be just stored in the Shopify database it will not get published in on your website unless you change the theme so that for product it actually displays those meta keywords on your product page, then they will be visible there. Right, so when we clarify that this is indeed the file as you need it to be, you can just close it, and actually you can, even with your modifications, you can then import this import results file so that whatever you edited is now imported there. And you just click import and then wait a couple of seconds, and it's done. It shows that two new products are created. And if you have some failed here, then again you can download the import results file and see what the import comment is. Let me just quickly open it and show to you. So there is a conversion comment, and then there is import comment column, which shows that in this case we had everything okay, and whatever app wants to tell you what happened to them, and in case of failed, there will be an explanation why a certain product failed. So, but we have everything okay, and now if we go and refresh here, then indeed we see our both products here in the Shopify store, like that, with all the description and variants and prices and counts and SEO, title description, handle is here, and as you can see, it's added to the collections, and it has those same tags and so on. So if we look at the collections, here is that, for example, subcategory, which has this product here in this category. Yeah, and that's how you migrate your products from Lightspeed to Shopify. Take a look at the other tutorials where I talk about how you can migrate to Shopify. Thanks, cheers.